A4. We're looking for A4.
I would say in this lane.
Yeah, stay in this lane.
But be on the right, on the left side.
On the left? Oh, you think
you
so?
See, there's two lanes.
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Don't go all the way to the middle.
Okay.
Just stay in the left, but because that really, still goes.
Because we're not going there, we're going to the next one.
Right. Yeah, so for now be here, and then when you turn, go to...
Where that truck was.
Yeah. Nope. Yep. Yeah, right here. You got it, boy. You got it.
Exit the roundabout onto Bristol Road.
I finally got it!
Continue for 1 mile.
And I actually was anticipating that.
Woo!
Fucking fourth gear. Sorry.
I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
It was actually down in the main bath area. There's this.
All right, dear. So what is this place? How is this special to us?
Behind us is the Crystal Palace. What?
Talk louder.
Oh, I thought you said stand up.
No,
okay.
Louder.
This is the Crystal Palace. We really liked this pub. We had a really good gin and tonic.
Uh-huh.
And it was a good atmosphere. And
We went there twice. We liked it so much. We went there twice. Yeah.
It was really good.
Thank you.
No, it's not. Good.
You're cured.
So we're trying to...
There's no buffer on that side. It's just working.
Yeah, so there's something weird coming. So,
I wish I could look and see how pretty this is.
You're going to kill the engine or something.
Avoid me instead of hitting the bricks.
Oh, okay.
That's kind of what I'm trying to do. Trying to be over on the right.
Oh, my God. So we're in this tiny little town. I don't think it's Ilchester.
Okay.
So we made it to Stonehenge. It was about an hour drive, right?
I guess, yeah.
Put the parking brake on. Okay. Yeah, and it was, Naomi was a great navigator.
You did great with the driving.
I didn't hit anything. I made one wrong turn on a roundabout because I thought she pointed a different direction. But that's really the only hiccup. Oh, no, but we also both got confused on a roundabout early on, and we pulled over to kind of get our bearings.
Yes. Oh, it was a double roundabout, and it was very strange.
It was really scary. But the funny thing about that stop was we ended up stopping for about 5 minutes because we couldn't figure out how to put this thing into reverse.
Yes, it wasn't like your normal. You go all the way over and up.
It's a six-speed manual, and it would not go farther to the left like you normally would for a reverse. I even tried looking some stuff up on YouTube to try to figure it out, and I abandoned that. And then I realized there's like this little sliding that under the knob, it slides up.
It looks like it's just the neck of the little
But it's a functional thing. Piece because it goes all the way down and you have to engage that by sliding all the way up and then jamming it all the way over. And we finally figured it out. And then that worked. And it's hard. I'm really glad I can drive a stick already. I drive a stick every day.
Yes.
Most people don't anymore. But it's still really hard because now I'm driving primarily with my right hand rather than my left. And shifting with my left rather than my right. So it's not a relaxing drive. I would love to drive my Honda Civic out here because it's so pretty and it's nice flowing roads. That'd be really fun to really get into it. But I'm just trying to not hit anything. So I'm not really having fun driving.
Yeah, and then he's yelling at him.
No, it's good.
Stop.
No.
Look right. Go.
Continue.
You're good. No,
continue
turn
what
here.
You're doing.
You're going to hit the curb. You're going to hit the curb.
It's working great.
So anyway, we made it to Stonehenge.
We made it. Yes.
So let's see. This isn't Stonehenge. This is the visitor center. So anyway,
there's a restroom.
We're there.
I don't care where we are.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we'll check in later. Bye. Those are burial mounds. All right, so we're taking our walk from Stonehenge to the car. And we're just out in the country.
We're trying to gear up to drive again.
Yeah.
I'm ready.
He's got to concentrate.
Gear up. No pun intended. It's a 6 gear. I haven't even been in fifth gear yet, though.
I don't think we're going to.
I don't know. Yeah.
So we're contemplating our next move. You'll see.
Thank you, dear.
How are you feeling?
Great. It's a Wednesday and we're having beer at 2 o'clock.
Yeah.
But it's what, 8 o'clock our time in the morning?
6 o'clock. Isn't it 6 o'clock?
Oh, 6 o'clock. You're right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's very early to start drinking.
8 hours. Yeah.
But it is your birthday.
Yeah.
So
we've acclimated.
Yeah. So we made it to London today.
Yes.
And we checked into our hotel early, which was very nice.
Yeah, it's a little apartment. It's very nice.
And now we're right down the street at a pub. Going to get our food and then go back and shower and decide what to do.
Yeah, we're going to go on the hop-on, hop-off bus, we think.
Trying to time things with the weather.
Yeah, so. It's supposed to rain the last 3 days we're here. So we're going to do a lot of museums then, right?
Yeah. Yep.
It's a good plan.
It's a good plan. All right. Well, cheers to your birthday.
Cheers.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for the trip. Good trip planning. Again.
Thank you.
Is it working? Your front is William the Conqueror's Norman Keep, known as the Great White Tower. Building work started in the year 1078 and it took 20 years to complete. Under the direction of Gondolf of Beck, the Bishop of Rochester. He had the tower built over 90 feet high, and the walls vary in thickness from 15 feet at the base to 11 feet at the top.
Hi. So hello. We're walking down the mall towards Buckingham Palace. We just thought we'd share some of our thoughts so far. Yeah. I was just going to say that one thing I'm going to remember the most about coming here is how many people are here. It's hard to describe.
8 million?
Yeah, and that doesn't even count the visitors. So
yeah.
Anyway, just everywhere we go, there's just gobs and gobs of people, but there's always a place for everybody.
Yeah, it's pretty efficient. It really is. They all the different modes of transportation work really well.
And when we've gone to restaurants and things, we haven't had to wait for anything for more than a couple of minutes at
Gordon's
most.
Gordon's Wine Bar, we waited for 3 minutes.
Maybe.
That was it. Did we wait anywhere else?
We waited to get into the Churchill War Rooms, and that was maybe 10 minutes.
Yeah, but no restaurants, though.
No.
Every restaurant we've gone to has
just walk right in.
Yeah, it's great.
It's crazy. And there's tons of people here. I mean, there's all these people walking on the mall. There's all this green space for people to hang out.
Yeah.
Anyway, just
very
that's
efficient. Very
one
efficient.
Of my memories will be how many people.
Yeah.
So, but
California.
It's working. It's working.
Could learn something.
Yeah, California could learn.
From London.
That's
yes.
For sure. All right.
So I think the main takeaway for me is the beautiful, well-maintained public spaces all over London. There are places I never even heard of that people just get to be a part of. It's like I've never been to Central Park in New York, obviously. But it seems like there's a bunch of those. And the only other place in California I can think of is maybe Golden Gate Park that has an urban public space like this.
Yeah.
But there
or
are
Balboa Park in San Diego.
Balboa Park. Yeah. But but that's not really urban. This is urban. This is in the center of the city.
This
All these
true.
Places. This is St. James Park, and it's gorgeous. It's near the palace, and it's just all these different types of people are here from all different countries and just enjoying nature and just being alone together.
Yep.
And it's well maintained.
What'd you get, Naomi? Oh my God, what is
donut.
That?
It's called coconut cream.
Coconut cream.
My babe.
I've heard you like coconut. Look at this. Wow.
Okay, get ready.
Go for it, go for it. Oh, that's nice. Look at that. Is it as good as it looks? Nice. And this place is called?
It's like a coconut cream pie.
Oh, you love that?
Yes.
And this is Bread Ahead at Borough Market.
Really yummy.
Good.
What do you have?
You know, I don't even know what she said it was. Partly because of the bells. Can everyone else hear those bells or is that just me? But anyway.
We can't hear you, but we can hear the bells.
This is, it's got olive, it's got different types of cheese in it and sourdough. It reminds me of the fougasse that we get at the at Wildflower Bread in Freestone.
Yes.
And it's great. It's perfect. You want some?
I want to taste it. That's awesome.
That's perfect.
How's that? Yummy.
That's a good looking pizza. Deserves a fold. Mm-hmm. That's great. Nice and thin.
Pizza.
Okay, so this is just interesting for being a tourist in a different city. So we are basically in the lobby of the Shard, which is the tallest building in Western Europe.
Yes.
And we know that you have to pay money to go up to this viewing platform, which is like way up there. It's like, I don't know, it's 70 stories?
Well, you get to go all the way up to 72.
72nd floor. It costs money. It costs like, what, $28?
Something like that.
It costs $28 to go up there. We're willing to pay that to go up and do that. We can't figure out how to actually pay to do that. We're sitting in a lobby and we have no idea how to actually give them money so we can go up there and look around and go, it's pretty high, huh? So we have no idea how to do that, so we may not. We may have to actually walk somewhere else to get tickets to come back to the same place to go up, to pay, to go up high.
We'll see, but I found this.
Okay.
It says, the main entrance and our ticket office can be accessed on Joyner Street. So now we need to find out where Joyner Street is.
Yeah, so we might have to leave the building to go to a different building to pay money to come back to the same building to go up on the elevator.
Look, map of entrances to the Shard.
Oh, here we go, there's a map. Okay, so we figured out, even though I think it was funny video, we really weren't in the lobby of the Shard.
No, we were at the station.
We're at a train station, basically, and that's why there were no signs about how to come from the Shard. We actually had to go back out and then figured out that that was the entrance.
We had to go outside, take a left downstairs, and then make a U-turn.
Yes.
Then it was very easy.
And then they were happy to take our money to ride the elevator up here. And it's a great view. I'm glad we came. This
amazing.
Is very cool. So
we'll
show you that in a second.
Gent who ran amok in Kent. Lately he's been overheard in Mayfair. You better stay away from him. He'll rip your lungs out, Jim. I'd like to meet his tailor. With the Queen, doing the werewolves of London. I saw Lon Chaney Jr. walking with the Queen, doing the werewolves of London. I saw a werewolf drinking a pina colada at Trader Vic's. His hair was perfect.